Hello everyone, Sharanu Sharanarthi. The first chapter of chemistry is matter in our surroundings. Matter in our surroundings. Before going to this chapter, I say introduction of matter. You know our surrounding have a large variety of things with different shapes, sizes and textures. Everything in this universe is made up of material which scientists have named matter. Examples: papers, food, stones, clouds, stars, plants and animals, etc. Now here arise question for you: what is the matter? Anything which occupies the space and has mass, it is called matter. Or another definition of matter is, matter is anything which occupies the space and has mass. For example, in our classroom, we use chalks, duster, board, charts, etc. Now I'll take here one example of chalk piece. Here the good example: this chalk piece occupies the space and has mass. And second example, duster is there. So duster occupies the space and has mass. Is it clear? Now we discuss classification of matter. So here three important aspects are there about the classification of matter. First one, early Indian philosophers classified matter in the form of five basic elements, that is the panchatattva. This panchatattva includes air, earth, fire, sky and water. And also ancient Greek philosopher had arrived at a similar classification of matter. Now second point of classification of matter is, on the basis of physical state, matter is classified as solids, liquids and gases. So I will give one example of each physical state matter solid. So ice cube, stone, paper, pencil, etc. So for liquids, examples are water, oil, kerosene, petrol, etc. For example of gases are carbon monoxide, oxygen, hydrogen, then etc. On third point, now we go for third point. On the basis of chemical composition, so matter is classified as a pure substances and mixtures. So pure substances may be elements or compounds. So mixtures may be homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. So now I'll give the definition of elements. So element is a substance that cannot be decomposed into simpler substance, or the elements are made up of same kind of elements. So example, 118 elements are given in our modern periodic table. So all these examples are the elements. So now I will give few example of the elements which are very familiar. Those are oxygen, hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, etc. So now we go for compounds. What is the definition of the compounds? So compounds means here the two or more elements are combined chemically in a definite proportion is called compounds. So for example of compounds are the water. Water formula is H2O. Then sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Just you observe that here the elements are combined chemically in a definite proportion of compounds. Next, here mixture may be homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. So the homogeneous mixtures are the solutions and heterogeneous mixtures are called suspensions. So I think this is clear. Okay, next we go for next point here. Physical nature of matter. There are five physical nature of matter are there. I'll read out one by one. First one is matter is made up of particles. Matter is made up of particles. Second one is the particles of matter are very tiny. The particles of matter are very tiny. Third point is the particles of matter have space between them. Fourth point, the particles of matter are continuously moving. The particles of matter attract each other. So these are the five important nature of matter, physical nature of matter. Now we go for one by one. First, physical nature of matter is, that is, matter is made up of particles. So this nature we will discuss with one activity. Here in the picture they are given. So beaker is there, spoon, you take sugar or salt, then water and a glass rod. So these are the important equipments for this activity. So now I will give the procedure of this activity. So take some water in a beaker and note its label. So dissolve some salt or sugar, whatever available, in it with the help of a glass rod. So that glass rod is used for stirring or stir the salt. The salt dissolves in the water, but the level of water does not change. The level of water does not change. This is because the particles of water get into the space between the particles of water. So here is the very important point here. So the particles of water get into the space between the particles of water. So this activity shows that matter is made up of particles. So water is also made up of the particles, sugar and salt is also made up of the particles, but total this activity is concluded that matter is made up of particles. So right, so this is you understood. Next we go for another physical nature of matter is second one. So the particles of matter are very tiny. The particles of matter are very tiny. So now this nature also we discuss with the activity or experiment. So dissolve 2 or 3 crystals of potassium permanganate. The formula potassium permanganate is KMnO4 in 100 ml of water in a beaker. You take 100 ml of beaker and then add or pour 100 ml of water in a beaker. Next, take 10 ml of this solution and dissolve in 100 ml of water. So in the same way, take 10 ml of this solution and dissolve in 100 ml of water. So repeat this process 5 to 6 times. This shows that a few crystal of potassium permanganate can color a large volume of water because there are millions of tiny particles in each crystal. So you take instead of potassium permanganate, if you want to do this experiment in your home, use Dettol. So total how many beakers you need here? 4 beakers or 5 beakers. So otherwise you use that glass, and each glass containing or each beaker is containing how much water here? 100 ml, 100 ml, 100. So you can see one baker to the another baker, the color can be little will be changes, but the particles are having millions in the last beaker of the water. So this is the second physical nature of the matter. The particles of matter are very tiny. So